The Aquascape iEngine is one of the most effective ways to control string algae in a water feature. It's a simple product. You've got a control panel that sends an electric signal down to a copper probe. This activates the copper, sends it in the water where it can actually control the algae. So what I want to do is actually give you a few tips and tricks on how to maximize the performance of the iEngine. One of the most important things to get good results of the iEngine is proper water flow. The control panel sends a signal down to these copper bars here. It excites the copper ion, and the copper ion tries to make a jump from one bar to the next. That's where the flow comes in. The flow is going to wash those copper ions down into the water feature where that algae can actually intake it. So without proper water flow, you're going to have that ion make the jump, and it'll start to plate up on the other side. So that's a pretty good indication. If you're troubleshooting an iEngine, doesn't seem to be working that effectively, and you pull this probe out and you see scale buildup, that patina-colored scale, it's a pretty good indication that you don't have good water flow. So you want to make sure you put this in good water flow. There's two different options. One, the iEngine comes with a flow chamber. So this is great for new installations where you're putting the plumbing in, pump over to the waterfall, and you intercept this in here, and this sits down inside. You get really good water flow off of this. The other option is, and this is more common if you already have an installation completed and you're coming in and putting the iEngine on at a later date, is simply just dangle this thing naked. You drop it into an area with good water flow, such as a skimmer. You drop it down in here or a pump fault, somewhere where that water is going to wash by and take those copper ions and distribute them into the water feature. So make sure you have good water flow. One water chemistry parameter that is important for both safety and effectiveness is actually your carbonate hardness. This is your buffering capacity of the water. So this is why we put a carbonate hardness test in here in the iEngine kit, is for you to test to kind of see a baseline where it's at. Why this is important. So anything below 5 degrees carbonate hardness, or basically 100 parts per million alkalinity, can be toxic to fish. Now fortunately, most water out of the tap is already above this. On the flip side of that, anything above 14 degrees carbonate hardness or 250 parts per million or greater, the copper becomes ineffective. It actually precipitates out and drops to the bottom of the pond, and the algae can't even absorb it. So you want to be within this window. So that's why we have the test kit to see where you're at. And then if you are on the lower side, there is a product we have called Alkalinity Booster. You put this in, it's a powder, and that'll actually bring your carbonate hardness up. Now, when I say iEngine is ineffective over 250 ppm of alkalinity or 14 degrees carbonate hardness, you just won't see any effect of the copper taking care of the algae. So when you test your water and you're above that, you need to bring that back down. A lot of times what happens, especially in smaller ponds with evaporation, you keep bringing the hose over, topping the pond off. It evaporates again, you bring the hose over, you top the pond off. All those minerals are left behind. Your buffering is actually left behind. Just basically the H2O goes up in the atmosphere. So every time you add water to the pond, that starts to creep up higher and higher and higher. So a lot of times, simple water change will bring that carbonate hardness back down, and all of a sudden you'll see the copper starting to be effective again. Now, with that said, if you're pulling water out of the tap, and out of the tap you're already above the carbonate hardness threshold, the iEngine's not for you. There's other products that we actually have to help control algae, because you're fighting a losing battle. You're already out of the tap water above the carbonate hardness, and it's not worth trying to lower it at that point. Use some other products to actually control string algae. If you're within those parameters, the iEngine should work great for you to control string algae. We're over at the control panel. Now, the iEngine definitely isn't a set it and forget it device. Okay, you have to maintain this. So I'll speak from personal experience at my pond. I leave my iEngine on level one. When I start to see algae forming, getting a little bit out of control, that's when I'll come over to the control panel and I'll raise it up. You depress the button and go into setting mode, it blinks, and I'll raise it up to 7, 8, 9, or 10. Then I'll monitor my algae levels. I'll watch for the next week or two as those start to actually kind of bald away off the rocks and come off the waterfalls and streams, and then I'll come back over to this and I'll drop it back down to one again. So this makes sure that my copper levels don't get out of control and get too high. It's one of the reasons why we actually include the test kit in here for you also to help monitor that way. But it also prolongs the life of the probe. So by dropping this down to one and probably running my pond at one about 90% of the year, raising it 3-4 times throughout the year, I get multiple years out of that probe. If you actually raise it up to 10 and just leave it on 10, you run into some safety issues with the fish, but you also actually are going to be burning through that probe pretty quick. So maintain this. I recommend dropping it down and only raise it when you actually need to. One of the most common troubleshooting questions we get is, why can't I raise my iEngine up to level 10? And there's a few different reasons, one of which we talked about earlier. If you don't have good water flow, that copper ion isn't washed down into the water feature. It's jumping over and plating up and actually suffocating the other side of the copper bar. So this will affect the ability for this to actually raise up to level 10. The other has to do with water chemistry. So if your water chemistry in your pond, if you have very low water hardness, not very many minerals in the water, there's not a lot of conductivity in that water. And that conductivity is what happens when the copper actually has a signal down to the one, that signal goes across to the other, and it actually gives a reading up here. So sometimes just simply raising up the conductivity in the water feature will help you get up to level 8, 9, or 10. So you can do that using that alkalinity booster, because this is basically minerals you're adding to the water. You can also add a little bit of salt to the water, and that salt will actually increase the conductivity. Now, truthfully, if you can get your ion gen up to 7, 8, even 9, you're going to be fine as far as actually the effectiveness of this. So don't try to battle that. It's if you're down at 4, 5, or 6. That's where you got to check your for good water flow and also check for the conductivity to make sure you have enough minerals in there for this thing to work effectively. All right, I hope these tips and tricks help you maximize the performance of the ion gen. Keep in mind our instructions. They have a whole troubleshooting section in the back. So a lot of the stuff I talked about today, you'll find in the troubleshooting section, as well as water chemistry parameters that you need to hit with it. If you don't keep the paper copy, like most people don't, go to the website landing page for the ion gen. You can download it there.